Here's one more example problem that's pretty similar. What I'd like you to do is, if you're feeling pretty confident, push pause and try this problem on your own. All right, let's walk through the description of the problem. We know that triangle CAB is isosceles. And in particular, A is the vertex angle. So A is the vertex. That means that B and C are the base angles. So B and C are congruent, and then the sides opposite B and C would be the congruent legs. So the side opposite B refers to that segment AC. The side opposite C refers to the segment AB. And so that means 3n plus 46 and 12n plus 10 must be congruent. So we'll go through and solve for n. I'll subtract 3n from both sides first. Then I'll subtract 10 from both sides. And lastly, dividing by 9 on both sides gives us a value of n. N is 4. So we solved, found n. That's done. Now we need to classify the triangle. So in order to classify the triangle, we need to figure out how long its sides are. So we'll take that value of n, and we'll just substitute it in to each of the three side lengths, 3n plus 46, 12n plus 10, and 8n plus 21. So 12 times 4 plus 10, that's 48 plus 10 is 58. And likewise, 3 times 4 plus 46 is 58. Now the one that we're not exactly sure about is this base side length. 8 times 4 is 32, and 32 plus 21 is 53. And so that means this side length CB is not congruent to the other legs. And so therefore, when we are to classify this triangle, CAB, all we know is triangle CAB is isosceles. And so in response to the question, is triangle CAB equiangular? Well, no way. And the reason it's not is a triangle must be equilateral to be equiangular, and this is not equilateral, so therefore it's not equiangular.